Having to constantly think about what you can or cannot eat. Remembering to test your blood sugar. Living with an increased risk of having serious health problems. Giving yourself insulin shots daily.
If you have a high glucose level for a very long time, years or even decades, and if you don't control it very well, eventually your pancreatic beta cells, the cell types that make insulin, they will also be damaged to such an extent that it's irreparable.
But what if we could make living with diabetes easier? What if there was a way we could retrain our bodies so they produce the insulin we need on their own? Potentially, type 2 diabetes would become more manageable, maybe even eradicated. We'll explore this groundbreaking possibility on this edition of LabTV News, Diabetes. Today, we're in the lab of Dr. Zhou Chow, principal investigator of his lab studying stem cell regenerative biology at Harvard University. He and his team are trying to retrain some of the body's beta cells so they produce insulin.
What we thought is perhaps the most simplistic way to make beta cells is to harvest some adult tissues from a specific person, for example, the patient itself, and then maybe create a technology where we can expand them and then convert them, basically now remake the cells into a new beta cell.
Currently, the pancreas is the only organ in our bodies that produce beta cells that create insulin. But what if it were possible to train beta cells in other parts of our body to perform this function? Reprogramming cells to take on the function of insulin-producing beta cells sounds impossible. But Dr. Chow and his colleague Dr. T asked where in the body might they find cells that could be retrained into insulin-producing cells.
We even look at the eye, you look at the eye, we look at the kidney, we look at the heart, we look at like everywhere from the tip to the toe. We had an interesting observation, a surprising breakthrough, if you will. It's just been published. The surprise is it turns out the cells in one part of the stomach, the so-called antrum, surprisingly, this is the best source, starting material to make a new beta cells.
The antrum, at the opening of the stomach, does this location contain the cells that Dr. Chow needs? One thing about these stomach cells, they can produce themselves in mass.
For example, if you have some bad gastrointestinal disease, you could have a diarrhea, you could lose tissues, but it will be replenished very quickly because of your own stem cells working to regenerate your gastrointestinal tract. But that allows us to now capture tiny pieces of tissues and be able to bring that to the laboratory and grow them and expand them to very large numbers. And now we can reprogram them to new insulin-secreting beta cells.
Someday, this therapy could help people with diabetes to create insulin naturally inside the body, eliminating the need for diabetes patients to inject insulin. Dr. Chow's discovery has the potential to improve millions of lives around the globe, and they are just getting started.
To try it, right? We have never done that. You're calling.
One day, Dr. Chow and Dr. T began brainstorming the idea of a mini stomach.
Over Christmas, New Year break, so the lab's very empty, just two of us sitting, you know, and brainstorming. We came up with this crazy idea. Maybe what we can do is to create a mini stomach whose dedicated function is to make beta cells.
We talked about it, said this is pretty, would be pretty cool to do, right?
Yeah, if it works.
If it works, it would be pretty cool.
Actually, like, initially, we didn't expect that it's going to work.
It turns out this can be done. You can create a small, tiny, mini stomach.
Slowly, we get something that, like, we get like a ball shape, and I opened it up. I was very excited to see, oh my God, there's something forming, like, after we transplanted. After I section it, do this, the histology, and I look at, like, I stain for the insulin, and inside that ball, there's so many insulin-positive cells. And I remember that, oh my God, there's so many insulin-positive cells inside the mini stomach.
This mini stomach could encourage insulin production, giving a person with diabetes a sustainable regenerative insulin boost. Their hope is to, as soon as possible, start clinical trials on humans to move their discovery forward.
There, I think, if you can develop an autologous way to make cells, beta cells, from your own tissue and transplant back, I think that's going to be tremendously exciting, a new therapeutic approach.
Congratulations, Dr. Chow and his team. We wish you continued success.
We're going to roll up sleeves and make it happen.
LabTV News Diabetes, going behind the scenes in labs across America to report on the latest peer-reviewed stories. To see more stories, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.